Geomagic Design X can help you reverse engineer mechanical components like this propeller. Once a 3D scan has been imported into Design X, we can leverage some powerful features and workflows to construct a parametric solid model. I'll start by creating this central hub using a revolve feature, which is probably something that most CAD users are familiar with. However, in this workflow, I'll create a sketch profile by referencing the scan data using a mesh sketch. If I create a mesh sketch on this plane, you can see a graphic that represents the intersection of the scan data and the plane. We can then use this graphic to generate entities automatically, or we can snap drawn entities onto it. We then have the option to add dimensions and relations to add design intent to our sketches. With a bit more work, we can complete the sketch. We can then revolve it to create the hub. As you can see, we have both the scan data as well as the solid body overlaid. We can individually hide or show these bodies and even compare them to check what we've drawn using the accuracy analyzer. We can clearly understand any deviations between our solid model and the 3D scan using the legend on the right hand side. For now, I'll hide the hub solid body and make a start on the blades. As you'll notice, only one blade was scanned, which isn't an issue because all three blades are identical and equally spaced. We'll therefore create one blade and use patterning to generate the other two instances. Before we do that, I'd like to introduce something called region segmentation. Region segmentation is a way to break up the mesh into different coloured areas to help identify geometric shapes. Without regions, the mesh is just a single selectable entity, and it can be difficult to use. With regions, the mesh is broken down into smaller selectable areas based on curvature. These regions give greater control and usability over areas of your mesh. For example, we could open a sketch on a planar region, create axes on cylindrical regions, or in the case of this propeller blade, we can create a surface body from this freeform region. I'll use the mesh fit tool to generate a surface from this region. The surface has been created oversized so that we can trim it back to the desired profile of the blade. I'll create another surface on the other side in the same way. We'll use these later, but for now I'll hide them. Next, to help us trim these surfaces, I need the profile for the blade's outer shape. This isn't just a case of extracting a 2D profile, because the edges of the blade curve in 3D. As you can see, if I open a mesh sketch on this plane, it initially produces a slice where the plane intersects the mesh. However, if we expand the silhouette's range to incorporate the blade's thickness, it'll give us the entire outer profile. We can then trace around this graphic with a spline. Finally, with the use of convert entities and some extending and trimming, we have our profile. This profile can then be extruded as a surface. We can then show the previous two surfaces and create a solid from all three using the solidify tool. We can then pattern the blade body to create two other instances, and the model is complete. If you're a SolidWorks user, you can transfer the whole model into SolidWorks using the live transfer function. This will recreate all items in our Design X feature tree, generating a complete feature tree inside of SolidWorks.